poništi.
They want to relax a little bit the international laws, not right now.
Može se u budućnosti malo blaži biti ti međunarodni zakoni.
Maybe some of the brothers and sisters that are in the cities, they should take off, get out. I mean,
možda braći i sestre koji su u gradovima bi trebalo da razmisle o povlačenju na selo, izlasku iz gradova.
When I say city, I don't say cities like you guys in Europe. I'm talking about Los Angeles, 18 million people, New York, 19 million people.
Kada pominjem reč grad, ne mislim u smislu u vaših gradova u Evropi, nego govorim o New Yorku i Los Angelesu sa nekoliko desetina miliona, 20 miliona stanovnika.
Imagine that it's the double population of Serbia, one city.
Zamislite dakle da je to dvostruka, dupli broj stanovnika Srbije.
Yeah, so to be caught in a city like that without food and without supplies, it will be horrible.
Zateći se u takvom gradu bez namirnica, bez hrane, bit će užasno.
My opinion is that this movement will turn into Sunday law.
Moje mišljenje je da će se ovaj pokret na kraju pretvoriti u nedeljni zakon.
Already the voices here in America and Protestantism are so much pushing for Sunday and religion.
Već se čuju glasovi u Americi u protestantizmu koji toliko insistiraju na uvođenju nedeljnog zakona, odnosno na povezivanju, uključivanju nedelje u celu priču.
Fear pushes people to religion.
Strah gura ljude ka religiji.
And unfortunately they don't care which one.
Nažalost, njih nije briga ka kojoj religiji.
You know, they think that forcing people to go to church on Sunday, that will be a solution.
Oni misle da će prisiljavanje ljudi da idu u crkvu nedeljom biti rešenje.
However, the time is very short.
Ali vreme je veoma kratko, kako god da razmišljamo o tome.
And if there are some leftover events,
i ako je ostalo nekih događaja koji još treba da se odigraju,
they will be succeeded rapidly.
Oni će se desiti veoma, veoma brzo.
Yeah, so my personal opinion is that Sunday law, it is extremely, extremely close.
Moje lično mišljenje je da je nedeljni zakon izuzetno blizu.
Okay. Časla, mislim da si zadovoljan tim pitanjem. Evo, Trifun hoće da pita nešto.
Valjan, možeš da me zameniš na 3 minuta, molim te.
Mogu. Trifun, izvoli.
Trifun, uključi mikrofon, Trifune.
Pa evo, sad sam uključio. Da.
Časlove, zašto se ne snima ovo? Molim te, snimaj ovaj deo. A snimaš, dobro je. Izvoli, Trifune.
Ja bih postavio pitanje, brato Livo, šta će biti sa imovinom, da li privatnom ili crkvenom imovinom koja na vreme nije upotrebljena
with properties, our personal properties or church properties, if we don't, how can I get, handle it rightly on time.
I koja će imovina prvo biti blokirana, vernika ili crkvene imovine?
Kind of property will be blocked first, private or church property.
I treće pitanje je iz kojeg razloga vodeći ljudi naše organizacije ne sarađuju da bi ljudi koji imaju bogatstvo ovoga sveta ne upotrebe ga na slavu i proslavu svetog Božjeg imena.
Why our leaders, our church leaders do not have more, how can I say, attention on our members who has a greater property and a rich, addressed to those who are rich, to engage all those richness to be used for the God's cause, if I understood correctly.
Yeah. I think that this question is late already.
Mislim da je odgovor na ovo pitanje, odnosno ovo pitanje malo zakasnilo.
Because every financial move is blocked, at least here in America.
Jer je ovdje u Americi već svaki finansijski veći pokret blokiran, zaustavljen.
So it's a rhetorical question. I mean, it's a question that the brother legitimately addresses. No question. No, I mean, I have no doubt about that.
Brat postavio je sasvim legitimno, to nema sumnje.
But those people in the church that are rich and they have, according to him, are rich and they have some extra leftover money and properties, they should have operated that stuff until now.
Dakle, moj odgovor na ovo posljednje treće pitanje je da ljudi koji imaju imovinu, koji imaju novac prema mišljenju brata Trifuna u većoj količini, trebalo je već do sada da ga negde upotrebe na pravi način.
I do believe that the Lord is taking in his own hands the work of God.
Sorry?
I believe that the Lord is taking in his own hands the work.
Dakle, verujem da u ovim trenucima Bog već preuzima posao, misionski posao u svoje ruke, kao što piše.
And I do believe that those who are engaged in sincere and labor now with doing evangelism, advertisement, warning the people, they will be conducted by the Holy Spirit.
Sorry. Da oni ljudi koji su sada angažovani već u misionstvu, u popularisanju naše vere, yes?
The Holy Spirit will guide them. So the leader of the General Conference will be the Holy Spirit.
Da će Sveti Duh takve ljude voditi.
Yeah, so God from now or he doesn't need our money anymore.
Dakle, u ovim momentima kaže brat Liviju, Bog više i ne treba naše novce.
You know, and this at the General Conference right now, we cut the salaries 50%, traveling 50%. In 3 months, if it goes like this, we will go unemployed and we have to work something with our hands and do voluntary work.
Konferencija već takva situacija da su plate smanjene, znači svim službenicima na 50%, sva putovanja su umanjena za 50%. Ako se za 3 mjeseca nastavi ovaj trend, mi ćemo ostati nezaposleni i morat ćemo nešto da razmišljamo da radimo svojim rukama.
So the rich people can keep their money. God doesn't need them anymore.
Dakle, bogati ljudi već mogu da zadrže svoj novac, Bogu oni više ne trebaju. Ne trebaju novac.
It's too late to make any move.
Kasno je već da se ulaže, investira i za neke veće pokrete.
I apologize for the manner I answer, but that's the truth and the reality.
Izvinjavam se zbog načina na koji odgovaram, ali to je realnost. I'm sorry. Thank you for your sincere
answers.
Brother Peter Lushevich was with us last Sabbath, and I just mentioned that it is time for us to take our all money from the banks and to put into the work of God. I didn't know that it is such a terrible situation already, but we left without commentary last Sabbath about that question. Ja, evo, preveo sam, ako ste razumeli većina vas, ja sam prošle subote, kad je brat Lušević bio sa nama, pomenuo to kratko, ali sam negde bio prekinut u momentu da je vreme došlo da povučemo svoje novce iz banaka, iz slamarica, ono što se kaže, iz banki, i da ga sada upotrebimo onako kako nas Bog vodi u misionstvu, predosećajući da je ovako već nešto nastalo, ali nisam znao da je ovoliko daleko otišlo, evo, prema bratu Liviju, to je već u Americi, bar tako. Ok, je li ima još pitanja? Ne znam da li vas vidim sve, ako ne, slobodno uključite mikrofone. Ne vidim vas sve, samo trenutak. Dobro, ima li još nekih pitanja? Ako nema, ja bih postavio jedno pitanje, brother Liviju. A, izvoli, Trifone, ti.
Postavio bih pitanje, neprovokativno, jako tako zvuči, iz kojeg razloga vodeća braća nisu više dala značaj svega ovoga što se tiče imovinskog stanja, da sarađuju u svetu sa onima koji su imali ili imaju još uvek velika bogatstva, a koji su pokazali u posljednjih 30 godina dobru volju da pomažu telu Božjem.
So the question is, why didn't the leading brothers from our church show more interest in cooperating with worldly people who are rich in their properties and who showed interest before in doing the work of God, in helping the cause of God?
Well,
sorry, not worldly, but our brother in who are rich, but worldly.
Ja mislim, Trifone, ako sam dobro razumeo, ljudi iz sveta koji su bogati ili naši?
Ne, naši ljudi, naši,
naši ljudi. Ljudi, okay. I'm sorry, not worldly people, our members who are rich.
Well, this question, it's how should I say? First of all, I'm not the leaders. I'm just one person.
Ja mogu samo to da kažem da ja nisam vođa ili vođe, ja sam samo jedna osoba.
In my horizon, I have three types of questions and three types of answers.
I ja isto imam tri pitanja i tri vrste odgovora.
I have answers that I can, questions that I can answer immediately.
Sorry, what was the last word?
I said, there are questions that I can answer immediately.
Postoje pitanja na koje mogu da odgovorim odmah.
There are questions that put me to study and then give you an wise answer.
Postoje pitanja na koje moram dobro proučiti i zatim dati jedan mudar odgovor.
And then I have questions that I have no answers.
A postoje isto tako i pitanja na koje nemam odgovor, niti ću
ga. I think that this question that the brother addressed should be addressed or directed to God, because I don't know to answer to that question, you know.
Mislim da ovo posljednje pitanje koje brat uputio treba zapravo biti postavljeno Bogu, jer ja nemam odgovor na to pitanje.
So my opinion is that we should not be concerned with what we should have done in the past.
Stav jeste da ne bi trebalo da nas brine ono što nismo uradili u prošlosti, već kako sada da iskupimo to vreme i kako sada da se ponašamo.
Ephesians 5:6, redeem the time because the days are evil. This is
kaže Efesima 5:6, ako se ne varam, pazite na vreme, odnosno u ovom engleskom prevodu kaže iskupite vreme jer su dani zli.
Yeah, to run around the world and find someone that is responsible, why you didn't do this, why you didn't that, it's waste of time right now, and I don't think that is priority.
Neko koji je odgovoran zašto ovo ili ono nije urađeno je gubljenje vremena.
The time is that we should be in peace with God.
Vreme je da se izmirimo sa Bogom.
Hvala, thank you, brother Liviju. Ja samo da dodam, ti ćeš prevesti kasnije, Stevane, da čuli smo kakva je situacija u Americi, ali u Srbiji, u Evropi, čini mi se, još uvijek može da se relativno dobro uloži novac u misionskom smislu. Recimo u Srbiji imate još uvijek mnogo siromašnih, mnogo onih kojima možemo da pomognemo, mnogo onih koji nemaju krov nad glavom.
We heard about the situation in America. I believe that in Europe and in Serbia, the situation is a bit different, that we can still invest money in a good cause to help to many of those who are poor, who doesn't have their own place to live or stay.
To su sve prilike za nas, da sada se pokažemo da smo ljudi koji su društveno odgovorni.
Those are all opportunities for us to show that we are socially responsible.
Correct.
I da radimo posao koji niko drugi neće.
And to do the work that no one else wants to do.
To me upravo podsjeća na ono iz Biblije.
That reminds me from of something from the Bible.
Onaj neverni pristav, ako se sećate, znate o čemu govorim.
The unfaithful servant.
Koji je na kraju prodao, ipak shvatio gdje je pogrešio.
Who eventually understood where he was wrong, what he did wrong.
I onda počeo da otkupljuje prošlost, ono što si ti, brat Liviju, pomenuo.
And then he started to redeem the past, what you mentioned, brother Liviju.
Da, zato mislim da bi trebalo da vrlo brzo stupimo u akciju, da iskoristimo ovo vreme koje nam se sada otvara.
That's why I believe that we should do this as soon as possible and to use these opportunities that are given to us right now.
To će nam otvoriti mnoge prilike za misionstvo i za svedočenje o Bogu.
God will open the way for missionary work and for testimony.
Moje pitanje za brat Livija je ne njemu lično, nego opet generalna konferencija.
My question is not addressed personally to you, but to the general conference.
Da li postoji neka zajednička strategija sad u ovom trenutku?
Do we have some general strategy at this point?
Upravo u misionskom smislu.
In this sense of missionary work.
Brethren, first of all, based on the resolutions, the global resolutions they have, we cannot move. We are stuck. We did not meet. We meet as an executive committee via Zoom as we meet today.
Na prvo mjesto ne možemo se ni kretati ni sastajati i kao izvršni odbor sastajemo se ovako preko Zooma kao i mi danas.
So everything is frozen.
Sve je dakle zamrznuto, stoji u mjestu.
We move to the virtual world, to television. We have filming and presentations to all the world.
Prisiljeni smo da se okrenemo tom virtualnom svijetu.
So when we will discuss in the next executive committee, we will plan for the next step in our organization.
Na sljedećem sastanku tog izvršnog odbora onda planirat ćemo sljedeći korak u organizaciji.
So imagine yesterday I had a meeting with you, today in the morning I have another one at 2, and the same time all the officers of the General Conference are all over the world right now via Zoom.
Ja sam i sinoć i evo sada na sastanku s vama sljedeći imam u 2 sata i istovremeno su svi služitelji generalne konferencije zaposleni, tako reći.
And now is the time when we make missionary work like never before.
I sada je vreme kada radimo i kada razmišljamo o misijonskom tom poslu kao nikad ranije.
I have lectures that I deliver every week and put in YouTube, and I have at least 3-4 languages translated this presentation.
Ja imam predavanja koje svake nedelje snimam i stavljam na YouTube i ona su bar na 3-4 jezika prevedena.
We have at least over 50-60,000 followers every week.
Svake nedelje imamo bar 50 do 60.000 sledbenika, pratilaca.
Only my presentations.
Samo na mojim prezentacijama.
How about Brother Peter Lausovic, David Zick and Walter Lukic and others?
Da ne pominjemo Lauševića, Petra, Davida Žica, Voju Lukića i druge.
Imagine that we are 45,000 people in the world.
Zamislite da nas ima samo 45,000 u svetu.
And just znači, one man, ono. Like one, personally one man, I interact with the full quantity of the people of God on earth and another half per week.
I kao samo jedan pojedinac, ja sam na neki način povezan sa celokupnim brojem Božeg naroda na ovoj zemlji plus još jednom polovinom tog broja.
So the work that is done through the virtual media now, it's amazing, it's unbelievable.
Delo koje se radi preko tih virtualnih sredstava, odnosno sredstava i medija je neverovatno.
I was called from a country.
Pozvan sam iz zemlje.
And told me, do you know who is listening to your messages?
Gde su me pitali, znate li ko sluša vašu poruku?
I said, who?
I pitao sam ko.
He says, is the police department leader in our city?
I odgovor je bio da je to glavni čovjek policije u našem gradu.
And another people from the political government, the party that is leading the government right now.
I još jedan čovjek iz političke partije koja je predsjedavajuća, koja je glavna.
And your messages have reached the Ministry of Finances and all these departments.
Tvoja poruka je došla i do ministra financija i mnogih drugih odseka.
Brethren, I tell you, God is taking in control his work.
Braćo, ja vam kažem da Bog drži pod kontrolom ovo delo.
We cannot monitor the impact upon the world.
Mi ne možemo znati kakav je uticaj naš na svet.
But now is the time.
Ali sada je vreme.
Where we can preach to the people of the world because the apathy is gone.
Kada možemo govoriti svetskim ljudima jer je apatije nestalo.
You know, people are scared.
Ljudi su uplašeni.
And we should stop to babysit our members. We have to preach to the gospel to the world.
Moramo prestati da budemo babysiteri našim članovima i da njih tako pazimo, već moramo krenuti da govorimo svetu.
The time is way past.
Vreme već odavno prošlo.
We spend time with cups dress, this, that, when you brush the teeth, all the insignificant things in the reform movement, and we miss the brilliant, the broader picture.
Zadržavamo se na čašicama za svetu večeru, na oblačenju, na pranju zuba, na nekim sitnicama koje nemaju baš puno važnosti i iz svega isključujemo ovu širu sliku i još veličanstveniji koncept.
Yeah. So we pray to the Lord that God will give us vision and wisdom, but I tell you, from the perspective of all the officers of the General Conference.
Molimo se Bogu da nam da viziju i mudrost, ali vam ovo govorim iz perspektive svih služitelja generalne konferencije.
We are 10 times more busy than before, man.
Sorry?
We are 10 times more busy than before.
Mi smo 10 puta zauzeti nego ranije.
Hvala Bogu za ovo iskustvo koje si nam iznao, brat Liviju. Zaista je bilo lepo čuti dokle sve doseže poruka.
It was nice to hear and to find out the outreach and the influence of the message you present.
Ruku je podigao
Dani i Renato tamo čekaju isto tamo pre toga.
Ko?
Dani i Renato su podigli ruku, oni su verovatno na telefonu.
Ajmo, ne znam, oprostite ako nisam nekoga video, ja sam ovdje...
Da, evo, mogu da postave pitanje.
Ajde, onda. Znači, Daniel i...
Renato. Yes, hi. I just wanted to say hi to Liviu. Liviu, we met in Sydney. We're from Melbourne. It was really good listening to your sermon. Always brilliant delivery. Fantastic comment.
Danny, I'm sorry. Please, during your talking, please wait for translation because we have to translate on Serbo. Okay?
I think there's no need.
Shorter sentences. Okay?
Yeah, she's addressing directly to Liviu, so no need to translate that, I guess.
Yes, it is. There is. Hoćemo da razumemo sve.
Ne znam. Samo ovo je lični pozdrav iz Sidneja. Okay.
Da. Please continue, Dani.
Okay. Hi, Brother Liviu. It's Dani and Renato here from Melbourne.
Hey, how are you? Nice meeting you, sister. Really a revelation, your presence, huh?
Yeah, always a surprise. But I just wanted to say, beautiful sermon, very encouraging, always straight to the point.
Želim da kažem da je ovo jedna divna propoved, veoma ohrabrujuća i udara baš u srž onoga što treba da iznese.
Just wanted to say, please keep preaching, don't stop. Everything that you preach, put it on YouTube, because we get encouragement from that.
Da kažem, nemoj nikad prestati da govoriš i sve što pričaš stavi na YouTube, jer jako cenimo tvoje poruke.
I will do so, sister.
Yeah, so just today we watched something because somebody sent us a link and it was the short sermon that you gave. And we just praise God for you and for the work that you do. And please don't ever stop and may God bless you and keep you.
Thank you, really appreciate it. Thank you, sister.
Hvala Bogu na tome što radiš i kažem, nemoj nikad prestati, radi to i dalje. I nek te Bog blagoslovi.
Thank you, Dani i Renato. Znači, brat i sestra, koliko sam razumio, iz Melbourne, iz Australije, ohrabrili su brata Livija da nastavi i oni slušaju njegove poruke. Thank you once again. Imali smo koga sledeće? Ko je digao ruku?
Brat Dragan Ivanov i Vladica.
Vladica. Dragane, ti do sada nisi učestvovao u ovim. Izvoli, Dragane.
Ja bih hteo da pozdravim u ime moje porodice brata Livija.
I would like to greet Brother Liviu in my behalf and in behalf of my family.
I želim da ga ohrabrim da da nastavi da sprema predavanja i to pre svega predavanja za ljude ovoga sveta.
And to encourage you to keep preparing these topics. And in the first place, topics and presentations for the people in the world.
Amen, amen.
Ja znam da je tvoja specijalnost proročanstva i događaja i posletka.
I know that your specialty are prophecies and end times.
pričaj tome i mi ćemo stavljati na naše društvene mreže i neka ljudi ovoga sveta shvate gde žive i šta će se uskoro desiti.
So keep talking about it. We will also publish it on our social networks so that people who are in the world can understand where do they live, in what kind of time or period of time, and what will happen soon.
Amen. Da, I will.
Da, zaista mislim da treba da ne dozvolimo da gubimo vreme na periferne stvari.
I also agree that we shouldn't allow ourselves to lose time on some not so important things.
Ti znaš na čega sve mislim.
You know what I mean. And...
kaži nama da znamo na šta
mislim. I da, pa rekao je već protivio, već je delimično rekao.
Yeah, you partially answered and
da mi govorimo o perifernim stvarima, da mi nismo organizacija za modne, kažem, informacije i ne znam ja šta.
Yeah, we are not organized to present some fashion details and stuff.
Da, mi treba da govorimo ljudima da se pripreme da sretnu Boga svoga.
We should be preaching to people to prepare them to meet with their God.
I naš plac i naš znanje u to treba da prvenstveno da utkamo.
And we should invest and use our knowledge in that direction.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, brother.
Veliki pozdrav i God bless you, my brother. My dear brother.
God bless you, brother Dragan.
Hvala, Dragane. Pre nego što dam reč Vladici, samo da kažem jednu stvar. Prevedimo ovo, molim te, Stevane. Zaista ohrabruje, ponavljam, to što naša braća iz Generalne konferencije uspevaju u ovom trenutku da rade posao koji je zaista uspešan.
It's very encouraging that our brothers from General Conference are able to do the work which is very, very successful now.
Ali cilj je da svaki član bude angažovan.
But I think the goal and the purpose is to make every member involved in this work.
Amen.
Zato bi od brata Livija voleo da čujem preporuke kako možemo mi da radimo.
That's why I would like to hear recommendations from you how, in what way can we work.
A naročito imajući u vidu da će uskoro mere biti povučene.
Especially taking into consideration that soon these measures will be withdrawn.
Nastupa vreme kada će i drugi religijski pokreti.
And the time comes when other religious movements,
za koje znamo da ih Bog ne vodi,
that we know God is not leading them,
takođe iskoristiti priliku.
Will also use their opportunities.
Razni harizmatski pokreti,
different charismatic movements,
već najavljuju veliko probuđenje odmah posle korone.
Are announcing the great revival right after corona virus is gone.
Da ne pominjem Mike Evansa, Wilkinsona i tako dalje. To su poznata imena.
Mike Evans and some Wilkinson guy, those are well-known names.
Oni su pisali knjige koje se prodaju milionskim tiražima pod naslovom Great Awakening.
They wrote books that are sold in million
pieces.
Da, million pieces named the Great Awakening.
Šta mi radimo i kako mi delujemo u tim trenucima?
What are we doing and how should we work in this period?
But please, before that imamo Vladicu. Znači nek ostane kao zapamćeno pitanje prvo Vladica.
So remember this question and let's hear brother Vladica and his question.
Braćo, da li me čujete? Ja nešto slabo čujem.
Čujemo.
E, u redu. Ja sam zahvalan brat Oliviju za ovu predivnu propovedi i upućivanje u kom vremenu živimo i da je stvarnost potpuna blokada i ne znamo da li će se odblokirati i kako će stvari ići.
I'm very thankful to brother Oliviju for this wonderful presentation and that we can be aware in which period of time we live, that everything is blocked and locked down and we don't know the direction in which everything will take place.
Koliko sam razumeo, on je uputio da pokušavaju da uvedu, da nam daju nano čipove i vakcine i tako dalje. više puta sa propovednik ili vodeće ljude u našoj crkvi postavljao pitanje da li mi možemo da primimo čipove, da li to ima veze neke sa nama. Od svi, većinom propovednika sam dobio odgovor, to nema nikakve veze sa našom religijom.
As far as I understood, there is an agenda to vaccinate all the people around the world and to somehow introduce them these nanochips that will control them. I used to ask many leading people from all our church this question, does it have to do anything with us? And most of the answers were that this doesn't have to do, this vaccination thing doesn't have to do anything with our religion.
Dok je on napomenuo da Bill Gates hoće da nam uvede te nanočipove, u kom načinu će to sve biti, moje pitanje je da li mi možemo da primamo čipove ili ne možemo da primamo čipove.
Wants to control us by this nanochip. So my question is basically, can we or can we not accept these vaccines and chips?
Okay, let me tell you something.
Da vam kažem nešto.
Number one. There are vaccines and vaccines.
Na prvom mjestu postoji mnogo vakcina različitih.
I am not a doctor.
Ja nisam lekar.
But based on what I have read,
ali na osnovu onoga što sam pročitao,
in the last month,
posljednjeg mjeseca,
in regard to this vaccine that Bill Gates is preparing,
u pogledu tih vakcina koje priprema Bill Gates,
it is obvious,
očigledno je,
that they want control,
da on želi kontrolu.
So this type of vaccine doesn't have much to do with the health of people.
Tako da ta vrsta vakcina ne bavi se mnogo zdravljem ljudi zapravo.
They say that what we talk now is just suppositions.
Ono o čemu mi sad pričamo su samo pretpostavke.
But they say that that will shut down your possibility to reproduce yourself, you know, to have children and so on and so forth.
Ali čak se govori o tome, ide se toliko daleko da će pokušati da se kontroliše i onemogući zapravo namnožavanje naroda, reprodukcija.
And in regard to the nanoparticles, they have been tested in China. China was the first field they did that, you know.
Kina je prva testirala te nanočestice.
Being a dictator, a dictatorial regime, it was easy for them to implement such things.
Za njih je bilo lako jer su i sami diktatorski režim.
And they work on artificial intelligence and stuff like that, and 5G.
Oni rade na tim na veštačkim inteligencijama i sličnim tehnologijama.
So they have big dreams.
Oni imaju velike snove.
They want to control the mind, basically.
Žele u osnovi da kontrolišu čoveka.
Sincerely?
Iskreno?
I don't believe that they will reach that stage.
Ja ne vjerujem da će oni uspjeti da sprovedu i da dođu do te faze da sprovedu svoje namjere.
Why?
Zašto?
Because it's against the will of God.
Jer se to suprotivi Božjoj volji.
And if you remember in the great controversy.
Ipak ako se sjetite iz velike borbe.
The Sunday will not be blindly imposed.
Nedjelja neće biti slepo nametnuta.
Every individual.
Svaki pojedinac
will take a decision for Sunday.
Odluku i opredeliti se za subotu ili nedjelju.
Very conscious manner.
Na jedan vrlo svestan način.
So how can I take a decision for Sabbath or Sunday if my mind is affected by the artificial intelligence and nanoparticles?
Kako dakle mogu da se opredelim i da donesem odluku da li ću da se opredelim za subotu ili nedelju ako mojim umom upravljaju neke nanočestice?
The Book of Revelation says.
Otkrivenje, knjiga Otkrivenja kaže.
God will come to destroy those that destroy the earth.
da će Bog uništiti one koji uništiše zemlju.
So I personally believe that everything will be, this atheism will be trashed in the garbage.
Ja lično verujem da će taj ateizam jednostavno biti sklonjen u stranu, bačen.
And the solution for the crisis.
And the solution for?
The crisis.
I da će rješenje krize.
It will turn into religion.
Zapravo biti pokušaj da se uspostavi jedna svjetska religija.
That's my opinion.
To je moje mišljenje.
But obviously I'm not God, I'm not a guru, I may be wrong, you know.
Ali očigledno ja nisam niti Bog, niti kakav guru i im ostavljam mogućnost da grešim.
Thank you, Luviu. Are you freezed? Are you still?
Surviving. You don't
surviving. Moving, okay.
At least I die like a hero.
Dobro, kaže, pitam ga da li je hladno, kaže, opstaje, kaže, na kraju će umreti kao heroj. Okay. Da li imamo još možda jedno pitanje da završavamo? I zbog nas, i zbog i Livija. Znači, još jedno samo pitanje, molim vas i da odstavim kraj.
Maybe just one more question if anybody has, and
let's go. Lenče.
Ko? Lenče.
Lenče.
Izvoli, Lenče, upali mikrofon.
Hvala na brat Liviju što nam je poslužio danas.
Thank you, brother Liviju, again for preaching to us today.
Ne samo u Srbiji, on je rekao u Srbiji, već i u Makedoniji poslužio.
Not only in Serbia, but also in Makedonija.
Amen, amen, thank you.
Ne znam da li on...
Croatia.
U koji sektor iz generalne konferencije, da li je za misionstvo, za literatura?
I don't know if exactly to which sector of the general conference do you belong? Missionary work, literature?
Myself?
Yeah.
No, I don't. Who is with the literature department right now? It's Brother Daniel Lee, which mm-hmm. is originally from South Korea. And the canvassing department and missionary department is a brother from Brazil. His name is Linares.
Mm-hmm. Brother Linares. Iz Brazila, a za literaturu Daniel Lee iz Južne Koreje.
Dobro, ipak ću ja da postavim moje pitanje kratko, jednostavno.
I will still present one question, very simple and short.
Sad u ovo vreme, šta možemo mi da uradimo? Da li da poklanjamo mi knjige naše ili da ih još uvek prodajemo? Naravno, na ljudi koji žele to da čitaju, ne svakome.
About our literature, what should we do nowadays? Should we sell still these books to people who want to read, or should we give them free? For free, sorry.
It depends. I don't think that buying and selling is still more on the market for long.
Zavisi. Ne mislim da će kupovanje i prodaja biti još uvek dostupni. Za dugo vremena. Još.
I think that it works like this.
Mislim da će biti na sljedeći način moguće.
If you give a book that is it's more expensive than other.
Ako nudite knjigu koja je skuplja od drugih.
You can say, look, this is a book, it's a gift of mine, but if you feel impressed by the Lord to offer a donation, you can do it. If not, it's your gift.
Možete pristupiti na taj način da kažete ovo je knjiga koju vam ja poklanjam, a ako vas Bog nadahnjuje i pokreće da date neku donaciju, slobodni ste da to date, ako ne, ne morate ni obavezati.
So it's very important how you relate with the people, how you touch heart to heart.
Veoma je važno kako pristupate ljudima i kako zapravo pokušavate da doprete do njihovog srca.
It's not just like a bully, reckless. Do you want a book? Buy? No. Next one. Next.
Da, ne radi se to tako grubo i bezobzirno. Da li želiš knjigu? Ne, okay, idemo dalje, nudimo drugo.
The spirit of love and compassion for people has to be displayed even when we sell books or we offer books.
U tom radu prodaje knjiga moramo ispoljiti duh saosećanja i nežnosti.
You know, for little brochures or little, you know, little brochures can be offered for free. You know, sometimes, you know, I buy things and I offer for free, you know, in a sense. So.
Male brošure možemo deliti za badava, besplatno, to ja radim nekad.
I want to share with you something.
Želim nešto još da podelim sa vama.
You know, we have a magazine that is called Reformation Herald.
Znate da imamo časopis koji se zove Glasnik Reformacije.
And this magazine was dormant for many, many years.
I taj članak, odnosno taj časopis je bio dugo godina obustavljeno je bilo štampanje i nije bio aktivan.
I offered this, I absolutely revolutionized the magazine.
Ja sam revolucionirao na neki način taj časopis.
I can offer your magazine and for translation. I translate that in 8 languages already and is going ballistic.
Već sam ga preveo na 8 jezika, ako sam dobro shvatio, i on vrlo brzo se širi.
I can email to you the electronic version of number 1 magazine. You translate, it's strictly prophecy. If last time events, excellent material.
Ja mogu vam poslati u elektronskoj formi taj prvi broj časopisa, pa da ga prevedete, on je u potpunosti pun tih proročanstava.
And this magazine doesn't have a date.
I taj časopis nema datum izdanja.
This is, I mean, I created, I redesigned when they gave me Reformation Herald under my jurisdiction. I said, I'm going to revolutionize this magazine.
Ja sam ga potpuno redizajnirao i potpuno, kažem, nov sistem i izgled uradio.
So this magazine,
taj časopis,
it's like the watchtower of the Jehovah Witness.
To je nešto slično kuli stražara, kako se zove, Jehovinih svedoka.
You know, they have the same magazine all over the world. In Japan, in China, in America, and Russia. All the same magazine.
Svuda po svetu, širom svetu imaju isto izdanje, isto časopisa. Bilo gde u svetu.
They go all over the world.
I oni idu skroz svuda po svetu.
This magazine can be used for canvassing.
Taj časopis može se iskoristiti za reportažu.
Why?
Zašto?
It doesn't have a date.
Jer nema datum.
It never expires.
Nikad ne ističe njegova vrednost.
And what you have in the magazine.
A ono što se tamo nalazi napisano.
Prophecy.
Proročanstva.
Issues for the families, gay movements, LGBT, all these things.
Gay, LGBT, pokreti, stvari koje se tiču porodice, sve te stvari aktuelne.
Number one, a magazine that started because I took over from January 2020.
U januaru 2020. Sam ja preuzeo taj posao i tad je prvo izdanje moj.
Number one magazine is called Domino Effect.
Pod mojim uredničnom izdat. Prvi broj tog časopisa zove se Domino Efekat.
And I do have the magazine ready. It's translated in 8 languages. Russian, Portuguese.
Spreman taj magazin časopis i već je preveden na 8 jezika.
So if you guys want to translate that for you, that will be fantastic.
Ako želite da to prevedete na vaš jezik, to bi bilo izvanredno.
And I will give you the issue number 2.
I već vam dati drugo izdanje također.
And you can use these magazines to give to the world because it's for the world, it's not for us.
To je drugi broj. I daću vam da to širite dalje po svetu, jer to je za svet, nije za nas.
I cooperate with the best writers in the world.
I'm sorry. As for the Serbian field, I have to inform you that we just made a decision according to what you said now, and we are planning to take over that issues and those Reformation Heralds, and to translate it on Serbo, I guess even brethren from Macedonia, the brethren from Croatia, they have their own, but maybe that's a suggestion, maybe they can do double job and to make even the second one from.
Da, znači, sam razumio, upravo je doneta odluka da mi u Srbiji preuzmemo, jel tako, to izdanje i da prevedemo na naš jezik, sad zavisi od Makedonaca i Hrvata, da li će i oni isto to početiti da urade, ali mi ćemo svakako to uraditi.
Ok, brat Vladica drža uporno ruku, vjerujem da ima nešto važno da pita, neka to bude, molim vas, posljednje pitanje, ako se slažete. Evo, brat Olivije je stvarno hladno i neprijatno, ima i obavez. Izvoli, Vladica.
Ja sam bratu zahvalan na njegov odgovor, ali ga nisam potpuno razumeo. Ja se nadam i verujem da tu tehnologiju i po pitanju čipovanja i nanotehnologije Bog neće dopustiti.
I'm thankful, brother Liviu, for your answer to my question, but I'm not sure I understood you completely. I believe that God will not permit this nanotechnology to be implanted and...
Yeah, but this is what I said.
Neće Bog dopustiti, ali u slučaju ako dopusti, da li mi možemo to slobodno da primamo, nema nikakve veze sa Božjom reči ili ne možemo da primamo?
But if he permits, if that happens, can we or can we not accept these vaccines?
Well, first of all, this vaccine never been tested.
Na prvom mjestu, te vakcine nikada nisu bile testirane.
And I don't believe that we should take anything by force.
I ne vjerujem da išta treba da uzmemo silom nametnuto.
Medicine. You heard about medicine in America.
Čuli ste kako deluje medicina u Americi? Kako radi?
When a government it forces you to eat something that you don't want. Or, no, if the government tells you what to eat and what medication you have to take in your body, that is a government that deals with tyranny.
Ako vas vlada natera i kaže vam šta da jedete i koji lek da unesete, ako vas silom natera, to je već u domenu tiranije te vlade.
So for me, the fact that they want to enforce a vaccine for 7 billion people in the world, that itself tells about the nature of these guys that are behind this.
Dakle, za mene lično činjenica da oni žele silom da nateraju 7 milijardi ljudi da prime vakcinu, već dovoljno govori o namerama i prirodi onih koji stoje iza toga.
I will be very, very reluctant to take nanoparticles in my body, you know?
Bane, pomozi mi reluctant, šta je?
Reluctant,
obazriv i suzdržan, bolje reći, suzdržan.
Ok, dakle, brat bi bio veoma suzdržan da, i obazriv po pitanju tog uzimanja, primanja vakcine.
You know, the body functions based on the immune system. We eat healthy, we make physical exercise, fresh air, sleep well, and that's the way that God created the body to be protected by the immune system, yes?
Da, imamo dakle te zdrave navike i Božje namere kako da održavamo svoj imunni sistem zdravim.
You know, I mean, I don't think that putting a tons of toxic material in our body will help us to be better, you know.
Ne mislim da će uzimanje velike količine tih toksičnih materijala doprineti poboljšanju našeg zdravlja.
Now, I don't want to go to extremes.
Ne želim isto tako da odem u drugi ekstrem.
I went to Africa.
Ja sam išao u Afriku.
And you have to take a yellow fever vaccine, otherwise you get sick 100%.
Morate primiti vakcinu za žutu groznicu, inače ćete se sigurno razboljeti.
Or I took pills, malaria pills, because if you don't, you get malaria for the rest of your life, 100%.
Možda sam uzimao i tablete protiv malarije, jer da nisam to uradio, sigurno bi oboleo od malarije.
So I'm reasonable with myself, yes?
Ja sam razuman.
But to go so far to put some technology and transform you in something else, that's way, way beyond
reason
of decency, you know.
Thank you.
Ali to, kad se povede pitanje o primanju tih čipova i nečega što bi upravljalo vašim razumom i odlukama, to je već potpuno druga stvar.
Hvala, brat Liviju. Mislim da bi ovdje trebalo stavimo tačku i da iscrpimo ovaj sastanak i ovu sesiju.
I believe that we should conclude here.
Ovo što meni samo, evo, apropo ovog poslednjeg što je Valica pitao, vakcine, da li ne, što bih volao da imam i da čujem, to je da generalna konferencija ipak izađe sa nekim zvaničnim saopštenjem.
I would also like, if it's possible, to have GC issue a official statement on vaccines.
Koje bi bilo baš ovako izbalansirano, kao što si ti sad rekao.
That would be balanced as you defined it now.
Znači, izbjegavajući bilo kakve ekstreme.
Avoiding any extremes.
I to bi pomoglo našim članima da se orijentišemo.
And that would help our members to orientate, to make position.
That's it. Brother Liviu, thank you once again.
It was
very, very useful to spend time with you, and thank you for all that you endure during this session.
No problem.
It was a pleasure, man. Rather to die of cold than to die of vaccine.
Okay. Okay, please stay alive. We need you still among us. Hvala i vama, braći i sestre, na učešću. Mislim da je bilo korisno slušati brata Liviju Todoroja i sve ono što smo danas imali da naučimo od našeg Boga i tokom lekcija i tokom ovih propovedi i diskusije. Ništa, do sljedećeg susreta. Želim vam Božji blagoslov i puno sreće, puno mudrosti pre svega.
Mi smo se molili, Bane. Mi smo se molili.
Ja sam sad mislio da završimo, znači upravo molitvom i da time stavimo tačku. Upravo molitva.